What are the biggest challenges facing companies looking to adopt DFMA, and how should companies tackle these challenges?
The biggest challenges I see are dealing with legacy products, for one. You know, companies already have a product design, maybe already in production, and they're looking to, you know, reduce cost or improve throughput on that product. It becomes difficult with working with the engineering team, because they have something that they created, they have something that worked, and getting engineers, you know, I'm certainly part of the problem here. Getting them to change their design could be very challenging sometimes, because they're confident in what they have. They see that it works. So moving to something else could be quite a challenge. So that's where I think that champion, you know, comes into play to help drive that thought process, try to foster the critical thinking there to be able to move past some of those roadblocks.
Now, working at Xerox with a specialty project and my work in the Air Force, you have huge tooling costs and not tremendous volume. So it's really tough to take a legacy product that has a limited lifespan left and retool it. So in that case, I think you need a new product so that you don't have to throw away tooling. And if you look at the history, when IBM did their IBM Pro printer, which is an historic item these days, but there they started with fresh sheet of paper and there's not a single fastener in final assembly. And they had the customer put in the ribbon with the thing of it's packaged so it'll stay fresh for you. That was the hardest part of the assembly. And if you look at something like tents that are used by backpackers, they would include a tube of seam sealer. That's a horrible thing to have to do in a plant. And apply it and let it dry before you package it so it doesn't get in trouble. So they give you a free tube of seam sealer. In the Pro printers, the cable, which could have been wired right in, was not. The customer plugs it in. And they use that as a safety device so that if the customer snapped off the cover with just a snap fit, they had to unplug it so they wouldn't have electric where they could get themselves hurt. So they do some really clever things, even if it requires adding a part or two and try and cut down the assembly time, which is money, money, money.
Are there any other challenges you feel are hindering people from jumping into DFMA?
A lot of them don't have enough background in today's production methods. So they cannot utilize all the things that are so good. So snap fits, they got to understand plastics and the bending and loading of plastics and the type of snap fits and things like cutting things out with a laser. Most schools are still just teaching lathes and mills, and they're not teaching how you can cut something out with a laser quickly, easily, and not a lot of tooling. It's not like stamping out sheet metal. So if your production quantities are kind of low, this is just a matter of programming. So they've got to know all these new methods, and they call it non-traditional manufacturing for stuff that's been traditional for years now.
Dave?
So I think a lot of what John said is true, but I also think that it's just a lot of companies are stuck in, this is the way we've always done it. It's worked. It's gotten us this far. And there's a lot of inertia to overcome. Goes back to why you need the champion and also why you need to pick some appropriate projects. Like John says, you pick a project and it's got extreme tooling costs. You're not going to waste that tooling and redo it. So you need to pick appropriate projects. Your champion needs to work on the inertia of the organization that really doesn't want to do this and doesn't totally see the benefit of it. And I think if you deal with those things, it'll roll out fairly well.